Start lecture 3. Today we are planning to complete page number 17 se leke page number 36 tak. So determination of nature of supply and levy and collection of tax, that's the portion we are planning to complete today. First, we'll do the same thing from summary. First, we'll understand in summarized form what all we are going to study today. The summary first we'll study, and then we can shift to the main book. Summary is being provided separately. At the top of this summary, you can write down that this is lecture 3 summary. You can also write down that it is about determination of nature of supply, levy and collection of tax, that is page number 17 to 36. I have already given the strategy. I wish that you attend my batch physically and mentally. When you go home, give me backup study of 2 hours, then shift to summary, relate yourself to summary. Then onwards, in ordinary course, you will be revising only from the summary. Only when you are stuck with some point, you can get back to the book and try to read it. Correct? So, let us try to understand the summary first. I'm on the page 1 of this summary. What section 7, 8 and 9 of IGST Act are telling us? That's what we are trying to study. But first remember, we are studying IGST Act sections. 7, 8 and 9 of IGST Act. For supply of goods and services, the location of the supplier and the place of supply are in two different states or two different union territories or a state and union territory is called as interstate supply. I think we are experts of this. I don't have to talk much about it, but he says if state and union territory, Union Territory and state. Supplier is in one state and place of supply is in another. For example, supplier is from Maharashtra and place of supply is in Andhra Pradesh and it is supply of goods or services. He is saying the supply of goods or services, the location of the supplier and place of supply are in two different states or in two different union territories or a state and union territory is to be considered as interstate supply. We are okay with that? Yes. Second, for supply of goods and services where the location of supplier and place of supply are in same state or same union territory is called as intrastate supply. This is state of Maharashtra. The supplier is from state of Maharashtra and place of supply is also in state of Maharashtra. Then this is what you call it as intrastate supply. This can be a state or this can be a union territory. If it is state, we'll call it intrastate. If it is union territory, we'll call it intra-union territory. Third point, location of such supplier or place of supply is in territorial waters is equal to in the coastal state or union territory which has nearest point of appropriate baseline is located. Again, this point we have understood. Say, for example, this is state of Tamil Nadu and 12 nautical miles. That is what we call it as territorial waters of India. For example, one vessel has come from the state of Tamil Nadu mainland. The supplier is there. And he has provided some services or some goods onto the vessel. Now, where is place of supply? From here, connect to the baseline. Which is the nearest state where this falls? This falls in the state of Tamil Nadu. Then place of supply is in Tamil Nadu. Are you okay with that? third point also we have considered. If it is in territorial waters, from there draw the straight line to the baseline, and it falls into which state, place of supply is in that state. Third point we have understood. So supply between two states is interstate supply. Supply within a state is called as intrastate supply, and supply within union territory is also called intrastate supply. This is we have to understand. For within union territories, we are not using any other words. We are using the same word, intrastate supply. We are not using intra-union territory supply. We are using the word intrastate supply only. So only two possibilities. It is intrastate supply or it is interstate supply. I think first part of the summary we are already experts of. But few points we have to learn. Following supply of goods or services or both shall be treated to be supply of goods or services or both in the course of interstate supply, and IGST will become payable to or by a special economic zone developer or special economic zone unit. This is something which we have not studied. Suppose this is state of Maharashtra, and state government of Maharashtra has preferred to have an SEZ here, special economic zone. To compete with China model, we have come out with this idea, special economic zone. Geographically, as you can see, SEZ is part of India, but for taxation purpose it is not part of India. It is secluded from the mainland. Inside SEZ, if you are doing manufacturing activities, you have no liabilities, no taxation liabilities, because though physically part of India, practically for taxation purpose it is considered not as part of India. Now, there is a supplier from Maharashtra, and he has provided a service or supplied goods to an SEZ. Place of supply is in SEZ. Whether this is interstate transaction or intrastate transaction, please understand this SEZ is within Maharashtra state. So actually, by normal understanding, this is intrastate transaction, but no, he says, so to or by, is it supply of goods or services to or by special economic zone developer or special economic zone unit will be considered as interstate transaction. So for example, there is one supplier in SEZ, and he has supplied some goods or services in state of Maharashtra. POS, place of supplies in Maharashtra. See, SEZ is within Maharashtra, so technically speaking, supplier is also from Maharashtra and place of supply is also from Maharashtra. So technically it should have been called as intrastate transaction, but he says no. He says, is it supply of goods or services to or by a special, focus on the word to or by. So supplier is in Maharashtra and supply has been in SEZ, and supplier in SEZ and supply is in state of Maharashtra. In both the cases, supply of goods or services to or by SEZ will be considered as interstate transaction. Here again he has used two words, developer of SEZ and unit inside SEZ. I want to explain you the concept of developer of SEZ and unit inside SEZ. For example, this is state of Maharashtra, and state government of Maharashtra has decided that SEZ should come here. State of Maharashtra has decided that SEZ should come here, and they have opened the tenders. Many people have participated. ILFS, Infrastructure Leasing Finance Company, got this tender. Now ILFS is going to develop this SEZ. We call him ILFS, developer of SEZ. What all activities ILFS will do? They will acquire land, they will level the land. Inside that, it's a big area, 500 acres of land or maybe 1000 acres of land. They will acquire all that land, they will level all that land. Tall walls are to be created because SEZ has to be secluded from the mainland. So tall wall with security guards is to be created. Inside the SEZ, infrastructure like road, water connection, electricity, poles, gardens is to be corrected. Plotting is to be done, and then plots are to be sold. I call him developer of SEZ. ILFS has done all that. ILFS acquired the land, ILFS has leveled the land, ILFS has created the walls, ILFS has created the roads within, ILFS has created the water supply, ILFS has done electricity supply, ILFS has done the plotting, and I have purchased one of this plot where I am going to start manufacturing activities, I am going to start factories, or from here I am going to start providing the services. Then you call me unit inside SEZ. He has used two words. One is developer of SEZ and one is unit inside SEZ. And he says any supply of goods or services to or by a developer or unit within SEZ will be considered as interstate. Please understand the first point. Also focus on the word to or by. Also focus on the word developer and unit.